I am Mrs. Visalakshmi, working as a social teacher in Trinity Matriculation High Secondary School, Namakkal. In this session, we are going to see 7th Standard History Lesson 2. In this session, we are going to see Art and Architecture of Tamil Nadu. Dravidian architecture is a indigenous origin. It advanced over time by a process of evolution. The earliest example of Tamil Dravidian architecture traditions were the 7th century rock cut shrines at Mamallapuram. In Tamil Nadu, the evolution of temple architecture took place in 5 stages: Pallava epochs, early Cholas epoch, later Chola, Vijayanagara Nayak and modern epochs. Pallava epoch. The Pallava epoch witnessed a tradition from rock cut to free standing temple. Rock cut temples were initially built by carving a rock to the requiring design, and then rocks were cut to build them temples. The Pallava king Mahendra Varman was the pioneer in a rock cut architecture. All the cave temples have simple sanctuarium cut on the rear side of the wall with the frontage protecting mandapa. On other side are two dwarabalahas. Narasimha Varman II, also known as Rajasimha, built the Kanji Kailasanatha temple. The Vaikunda Perumal temple at Kanjipuram was built by Nandivarman II. Mahabalipuram is built of cut stone rather than caved out of rock caves. It has a two shrines on decorated to Shiva and other to Vishnu. The Tamil Dravidian tradition is exemplified by rock cut monuments such as Panchapandava Rathas, namely Draupadi Ratha, Dharmaraja Ratha, Bhima Ratha, Arjuna Ratha and Nagula Sahadeva Ratha. The other walls of the Rathas, especially of Arjuna, Bhima and Dharmaraja, are decorated with niches and motifs. The niches have the sculptures of gods and goddesses, monarchs and seen from mythology. The Arjuna's penance carved on the face of a granite builders is a manufacture relief measuring approximately 100 feet long by 45 feet high. Pandya temples in the Pallava epoch. Early Pandyas were the contemporaries of the Pallavas. Unlike the Pallavas, Pandyas installed diets in the sanctum in the cave temples. More than 50 cave temples have been found in the different parts of the Pandya empire. The most important of them are found in the Malayala Kurichi, Anaimalai, Tiruparankundram and Tiruchirappalli. These caves were dedicated to Shiva, Vishnu and Brahma. In the Shiva temple of Pandyas, the linga is carved out of the mother rock. The figure of Nandi is also carved out of the rock. The Shivalingam in the sanctums is installed in the center with enough space all around it. The sanctums also have a drainage canal the pillars are divided into three parts and are of different size. The pillars have no uniform ornamentations. The backside walls are divided into four niches, on which the base relief image of Shiva, Vishnu, Durga, Ganapati, Subramanya, Surya, Brahma, and Saraswati are carved out. The Dwarabalahas figure on either side of santons. Arched structural temples are significant part of the Pandya architecture. The illustrious example for rocket style is unfinished Kaluhumalai Vetvan Koil temple. The Vetvan Koil, a monolithic temple at Kaluhumalai, is climbed out of a huge builder of four sides. At the top of the temple, sculptures of Uma Makeswara, Dakshinamurti, Vishnu, and Brahma are found. Meenakshi Amman temple in Madurai and Nellaipuram temple in Tirunelveli represent examples of Pandya's architectural style. Sculpture. Tirupparankunram, Anaimalai, and Kaluhumalai have the bas relief of many deities. Shiva, Vishnu, Brahma, Parvati, Subramanya, Ganapati, and Dakshinamurti. These are some remarkable images of the cave temples. Many early Pandya images unearthed from Madurai and its surrounding areas are now in Tirumalai Nayaka Museum at Madurai. Paintings. Caves at Sitanavasal, 15 kilometers away from Pudukottai, and at Tirumalapuram in Sankaranar Kovil Taluk, Tirunelveli district, have outstanding early Pandya paintings. Sitanavasal was the residential cave of the Jain monks. They painted the walls with fresco paintings. Unfortunately, we have many of those paintings among the surviving ones. The lotus ponds is notable for its excellent excavation of colors and expositions of the scene. The image of lotus flowers, leaves spread all over the pond, animals, elephants, buffaloes, swans, and a man who plucked the flowers look brilliant. Early Chola epoch. The Cholas came in limelight in AD 850 under Vijayalaya Chola and continued to govern the region for about 400 years. For the early Chola epoch, the temple at Dharapuram near Dindivanam in Tamil Nadu was mentioned. The early Chola architecture followed the style of Sembian Mahadevi temple with increased number of Devakosta. Figure can be classified as belonging to the Sembian style. Tirupparambiyam is an illustrious example of early temple that was refashionized in the days of Sembian Mahadevi. Later Chola epoch. The maturity attained by Chola architecture is reflected in the two magnificent temples of Tanjavur and Gangaikonda Cholapuram. The magnificent Tanjavur big temple dedicated to Shiva, completed around AD 1009, is fitting memorial to the material architectures of the time of Rajaraja. At the time of big temple of Tanjavur was constructed, it was a huge temple complex. The 216 feet Vimana is notable as it is one among the tallest man-made sahas on the world. Next one, Gangaikonda Cholapuram served as a Chola capital for about 250 years until the decline of Cholas and the rise of the Pandyas. The Pragadiswara temple of Gangaikonda Cholapuram, built by Rajendra Chola, is undoubtedly as worthy a successor to the Pragadiswara temple of Thanjavur. Dharasuram. Dharasuram near Kumbakonam is a later Chola period temple rich in architectural splendor, designed to Aireswara Rajaraja II constructed this temple. Temple is another landmark of Chola architecture. Later Pandyas. The contribution of later Pandyas to South India art was significant. A case in point is the cave temple at Pillaiyarpatti, belonging to 13th century. This temple is important both for its sculptures and for an inscription. A beautiful Ganesha is carved facing the entrance. The importance of the figure referred to Desi Vinayaka in the cave inscription is that there are two arms with the trunk turned to the right. Vijayanagara epoch. During the Vijayanagara epoch, a new form of construction emerged. It is the mandapam to where the gods are carried every year. Pillars outdoor mandapams are meant for public rituals, with the ones in the east serving as a waiting room for devotees, which adorn the large temples. These mandapams attract attention for its monolithic pillars. On these pillars are sculptures horse, lions, and the gods. The Kailayan Mandapam at Kanchipuram and the Velur are notable examples. The most celebrated of these mandapams in the temple of Madurai is the Pudu Mandapam. The practice of fitting the niches with sculptures continued during the Nayak period. These are increased use of major sculpture figure as found at the Alayanka Nambi temple at Thirukurangkudi and the Gopalakrishna temple in the Ranganatha temple complex at Srirangam. The southern festival mandapam of Adinatha temple at Alvar Tirunagiri and a porch of Nellayampuram temple at Tirunelveli are other notable examples. In Tamil Nadu, the images of design attached to composed column gradually feed themselves from the core column. The thousand pillars mandapam of the Meenakshi Sundareswar temple at Madurai, Radhi Mandapam at Thirukurangkudi and Venu Mandapam temple at Nagalin illustrates example for the mandapam architecture of this period. Modern period. The Sethupathi as the federates of Madurai Nayaks ruled Ramanathapuram and contributed to the Ramanatheswami temple architecture. In the temple of Rameswaram, the phenomenon of corridor is striking. It is claimed that the temple has the longest set of the corridor in the world. The temple has three sets of corridors. The outer part of the temple's corridors has the height of almost 7 meters and streak for about 120 meters in both the eastern and western direction. The corridors to the north and the south on the other hand are about 195 meters in the length. The outer corridor is also remarkable for the number of pillars that supported it, which is over 1,200 in number. Moreover, many of these pillars are decorated by ornate carvings. The innermost set of the corridors is the oldest of the three. In this lesson, we discussed the Pallava period features sculpture rocks. Early Chola period was marked by a grand vimanas. The later Chola period was known for beautiful gopuram. Vijayanagara period's unique features was the mandapam, and the modern period was when the corridors were given prominence. Thank you.